All right, well, I left you guys on a cliffhanger in the last episode, but here's where we're at. A guy named Fred got some pants, but no weapon. A pyromaniac, an herbal entrepreneur. He's basically on the run from some bogeys who are out to kill him. And now I've got to protect him because he's a new colonist of my base. So let's do that. Spork. Mana. Actually, not Spork. Mana. DFuxa. Quarish Knight. You guys are going to draft up. Get here. Fred, grab yourself a knife. And here we go. And while we're at it, I should probably rename this guy. So we'll call you BossGalaga. So BossGalaga has joined the group. It's too bad I don't have all turrets yet, but nothing I can really do about that just yet. Probably keep in mind there's a marble wall down here, but whatever. So, he came down from this direction. That means that the other guys are probably going to join him. And here's the raid. So these guys have come to basically, like, you know, take revenge on us. We've got ourselves an archer, another archer, and another archer. They'll have to be dealt with. Spork's going to have some fun afterwards, I guess. I should probably get these guys in position for, you know, an attack, so the tribes people are coming to kill us. So, something I don't know about tribes people is that they're very, very good at basically outnumbering you. And you have to watch out for it when they outnumber you. I'm going to stand right there. Man, I can go behind a tree, perhaps. Crush, I can get over here. You're going to get drafted. And we're going to start the fight. So these guys are, as you can see, are taking cover. I'm going to rush them with my guys. I'll get my guys to advance. There goes one of these tribes people. Now they're fleeing because, you know, they're taking damage. Gonna undraft you. I'll maybe try and pursue him for a little bit. And I'll have these guys go after him if possible. Managed to kill two tribespeople, the chief and a shaman here, apparently. We'll strip their bodies of all goods because they got some nice goods that they can make use of. And I'll bury their bodies in these graves. I'll have to build up some more graves, I guess, at this point. So, before I forget about doing that, let's build a bunch more graves for them. And there we go, we killed the last tribesman. It is a complete massacre. I'm going to have to build another bed for BossGalaga, so we'll get down that, I guess. Build a bed in here, I guess. Might as well just keep building them. Borskun has some, you know, job to do, basically healing up Korsh Knight and BossGalaga because they're, you know, injured, but whatever. Okay, you're actually going to strip all these guys, me. And after we strip them all, we'll start burying them. And well, now they'll bury these guys. And yes, BossGalaga will need some treatment as well as Korsh Knight. We're getting some treatment going on here now. There's some minor wounds in that fight there. Nothing too serious, but you know, serious enough. There's some beds. Those would be good for BossGalaga to go into. Set that there. I'm thinking about how I'm gonna basically power up these places though at this point. I may want to run a wall down this area. Why ask they're doing all the mining over there? He's gonna go rest finally. BossGalaga, he needs to be he's got a few problems. He's got acute pain, other stuff going on. Needs a little bit of treatment. I don't know why is Spork in a little bit of pain? I have no idea. Is this like, you know, scars are hurting him a little bit? Whatever. Good thing about BossGalaga here is that he's gonna be another, you know, worker to do stuff with. You can be a patient. Bed rest. You can flick switches. Looking at what he's good at, BossGalaga isn't good at a whole lot, but he can hunt. He's technically okay for mining, I guess. Plant cutting. He's good art, apparently. I'll make him another hauler and cleaner, just like Korsh Knight. And for those who don't know, BossGalaga, he's not a YouTuber like the other four, you know, people you see here, myself included. BossGalaga is the owner of the Roguelikes Steam group on Steam. Might want to check him out. Anyways, BossGalaga, from an early age, he was a pyromaniac that had an unhealthy fascination of fire. He would set refuse heaps ablaze and become so entranced by the flames he would absolutely burn himself. One day, while playing with matches, he carelessly burned down his home with his parents and siblings still inside. So he's got good artistic but bad social in their cooking. And he's an herb world entrepreneur, which is kind of interesting. In the herb worlds, most suffer, but someone has to run the corporations. BossGalaga learned the skills of the trade, greasing palms and technical analysis. He's a social intellect machine, so he's good at research, good at social, but bad at social because he's a pyromaniac. Also bad at cooking for some reason. I guess I'll probably make him like mine. He's also apparently gay, but whatever. He's good at shooting, I guess. Might want to get him a bow. So the sport's gonna do some healing, finally. Oh, of course I got fully healed. So he's got blood loss, he's got torso problems, he's got left kidney problem. He's in severe pain. Looks like Corn Snipe woke up early. It's worth knowing you can actually change when these guys work around. And apparently Corn Snipe likes to work, you know, like the rest of these guys, let's, you know, normal times. At some point, I may want to have some night owls, but for now, we don't really care. How's your health? Looking pretty good. It's not bleeding anymore. I may want to set this up so that, you know, these guys basically work and do stuff at specific times, but for now they're doing fine with, like, you know, having anything in sleep. I'm good with it. There's a lot of blood over here. These guys will have to clean that up. There was Crush Knight to do some more mining. And there goes the power again, because, you know, power. BossGalaga's got some critical problems here because he's in the dark, I guess. He's in a shared bedroom. He witnessed someone's death. He's urgently hungry. But a lot of his stuff will be fixed when he wakes up. Oh, nice. He gets to eat at a table here. Oh, he got food poisoning, didn't he? Nope, he went to bed. Bosco is fully healed. Man, I got food poisoning. This is all roofed up, right? No, apparently it's not. Okay, let's fix that up. That's gonna be roofed up like so. Alright, let's actually make our stockpile at this point. So, this is a stockpile over here, of course. Going to be for manufacture, raw resources, items, and weapons and apparel. That's fine, we'll put it all in there. We're just going to mine over here, apparently. That's fine. This is a very long wall. So we got a big building over here. Start moving some stuff over. Should probably get rid of this, you know, so they actually start moving that stuff. Low medicine, that's a bit of an issue because I don't. Oh, I guess it's because I hit this. Never mind. Whatever, it's time to move all the stuff in here. This'll make some room for my solar panels, which should be good. You know, thinking about it, I might need a lot more grays in the future again, so... Oh, you can't dig it right there. Okay, that's fine. Make some more grays there when you get the chance. Oh, we're going back to sleep. Well, that's fine. Got cloth park on apparently now. I wonder where we got that. There goes our power again. We'll build a couple of those. Slowly moving up everything. My break bracelet and Cornish Knight. What's happening with you? Yeah, it's one thing after another, you know. These guys will, like, have these problems. He's naked, apparently, so he doesn't like that. He wants to actually wear something. Well, he'll stop. He'll get to that eventually. He's playing chess with himself, I guess. Well, whatever. Whatever works for you. Nice! We're getting medicine here. We're getting stuff researched. Well, I'm not getting some pemmican, but... I may want to start getting stuff like smelting going at some point. Nice, so we need this eventually. Yes, there's lots and lots of stuff, as you can see, you can do here. I wouldn't mind getting some hospital beds. High-tech research bench. I need to get a research bench made for that. Well, I suppose it's time to deconstruct this, and we'll build a, you know, a high-tech research bench right here. It's gonna be an awful lot to build, but whatever, it'll be worth it. You know, this counts as medicine, I guess, so I really should be putting it in, well, maybe it's not that big of an issue. Herbal medicine will last a while. You might be good. You know, I forgot to do something important. There's actually no door here. We'll build that there. Now this might need power. That's fine, I'll have power in a bit. Mine all out of the way, I guess. A heat wave. An unusual heat wave has begun. Watch out for heat stroke. That's something to be careful of. Temperature's gonna be really, really hot. Me, I'm not a fan of the heat. Both literally and characteristically. We'll make this out of sandstone blocks. I suppose you want clothes? Yeah, you still want clothes and stuff. You're very cold for some reason. Probably because you're in a refrigerator. Okay, we'll build some power. Oh, we're gonna go to sleep now, I guess. He's got a cloth parka on. He needs to have some pants on, is the problem. I guess there was no pants from these guys I killed. Well, we'll have to start looking into constructing some pants, I guess. Enough to like chop out or mine out just a 3x3 square here? Not really. I'm gonna go like this. I'll build myself a letter bench or something here. Probably should haul that away. Haul that all away. Well, we got some rain. That's even more perfect. Rain on a, you know, a hot day. Sporks apparently are having problems. He ate well at a table. He's feeling bad. He slept in the heat. He's in a little pain. He's just out, having a bad day, so I guess I really should start looking into maybe deconstructing one of these walls and building an air conditioner unit in here. Maybe over here too. So, temperature, cooler. Whoops, a conduit went boom. A fault in the electric conduit caused a short circuit. All of the energy in the connected batteries have been discharged in an electrical explosion. That's a bit of an issue. Damaged my walls, too. At least it was raining outside, so it burned out. I'll have to build that there. Probably start getting my high-tech research bench here made at some point, and it's a lot bigger than apparently than I figured it would be. So I'm gonna have to mine this out. So both Spork and BossGalaga are having problems, probably with the heat. It's extremely hot, they don't like that. Well, everyone's eating over here, it's fine. Or they're not. What am I missing here? I need components apparently. We've run out of components. I'll have to go mine some out. Get that all ready for building stuff. Mostly people's needs are getting better. That's good. Build that right there. Oh, we got some pork brought away. Now we're running out of power, is why. I'll build more of those. Now, we may want to build our table over here at some point, but we'll get to that eventually. He's still naked. Gotta get him some pants. So let's do that. We'll make a bill for a pair of pants. Make some pants out of some leather or something. Someone will do that. Hey, I built an Aladar, cool. It's got enough power to it, but eventually I'll have power. Kinda need to get some more steel. So I have to deconstruct some steel walls or something somewhere. That's walls. That's granite wall. Slate. Marble. There is a steel wall I could deconstruct. Over here, but I'm not sure why I deconstruct that just yet. There might be something bad behind that wall, so I'm being very careful. I'll be very careful what's on behind some walls. There's some compacted steel up here, though. Whoa! This Spork's gonna have an air critical break risk. Yeah, mental problems can be a big issue. There we go, we built a stained lamp. Filling up our doors. Bing, bang, boom. Hey, heat wave over. Great. Now I just have to make sure there's power for this place. Let's mine out these walls here. Actually, you know what? Let's cancel building that. Build over here, where it's nice and accessible to the walls. And of course, Pork is having his, you know, problems. Gonna have to deal with that eventually, but whatever. These walls up again. And we're going to sleep. Well, well, this stuff will be not refrigerated very well, but whatever. See, the problem is I'm having to refrigerate this area over here as well. Because, you know, like, you know, this is connected to it. Probably remember I can do this over here now, too. We'll definitely get a chance. That's out of the way. A lot of steel over here, which is good. There we go, power. A little bit of components too. One thing I know is I'm not seeing a whole lot of components on the map, so that's a bit of an issue for me. Components. I may have to actually buy components. There's some more. Ooh, a silver ore over here. Corvus Knight started a social fight with BossGalaga recently insulted. Apparently these two don't like each other very much. So yes, Corvus Knight. Chit chat, didn't like each other. I guess Corvus Knight doesn't like a lot of people. Insulted. Disfigured. Harmony, disfigured, insulted. Well, they're no longer social fighting, but now he needs rescue. Bit of an issue. Go rescue him. So it's good that Spork gets to do all his stuff there. Improve his medicine a little bit. Nice, we got these getting built. That was not close enough, apparently. So power. Build that there. So that's good. They'll keep this place nice and cool if they ever, you know, have like problems indoors. Oh geez, he got food poisoning. Oh well. Nothing to really do about it. Of course, he's having a break risk. He's insulted twice, he got disturbed sleep, he's naked, cramped environment, shared bedroom, ugly environment, slept in the heat and feeling bad. He's also wearing bad apparel. There are people who have a relationships of colonists or prisoners in the arriving group. Oh, cool. So, apparently, this village, Aaron, is the nephew of colonist DFuxa. What's up? This is this guy over here. Apparently, it's my nephew. This is a group. I guess they're traveling through. Didn't say they're trading. Fully healed, good. Gonna go play some chess. Who's my tailor, by the way? That's actually Spork. Spork, you're actually gonna do a little bit of tailoring, I guess, when you wake up. He's gonna watch the dawn. A group of pirates from Dark Knuckles has arrived nearby. They're attacking immediately. So they're attacking. Alright, well. We got a clubber, a pistoler, and he's carrying go juice. Injecting go juice. I'm not sure how important that is gonna be, but, go juice! Alright, well, everyone gets to wake up. We're under attack. You got a pump shotgun, apparently. Ow. You guys get to go over here then. Or not. Someone's coming out over to say hi. There goes him. Well, this is melee attack. So apparently we're gonna capture someone. That'll be interesting. Get to see me at first capture. There goes him. No escape. Ooh, we captured two of them. Interesting. Capture her. Oh, we need a bed for it. So here's something I know about like capturing people. You can capture people, but you need to have room for it somewhere for them basically to you know, be captured. Which I don't really have any room for them yet. I suppose what I could do, I could make like, you know, some spots up here. Out in the middle of nowhere. Build that right there. These are just some, you know, sleeping spots. Nice, some silver. There's some go juice too. So go juice, a synthetic combat drug developed for space marines during the early days of interplanetary warfare. Go juice blocks pain and increases the user's melee and shooting abilities. It also enhances movement speed. Military chemists who created it were never able to remove its addictiveness. Some saw it, this as a downside, others saw it as a benefit. Oh, boss guy's throwing up. You know, I actually want you to go build that. Since I'm pretty fast. All of us got pretty much injured except for Spork, so Spork's gonna have some, you know, some stuff to do. Actually stand right there. Apparently I'm bleeding a little bit. I'm just having some trivial blood loss, it's fine. It did take some damage to the torso apparently. I may want to have medicine closer to our, you know, where we're going to be at some point, but we'll worry about that another time. For now, let's get this built. There we go. Set this for prisoners. So now I got our prisoner bunker. Capture him. Maz, okay, great. You get to capture him, and then you're good to go to sleep, I think. The fort's gonna have a nice little travel all the way up here, but whatever. There's him. So, here's a prisoner. Prisoners are basically like characters you can capture and try and recruit to your base, and you're actually pretty much worth recruiting. You're very neurotic, you're ugly, you're nervous. Now, the only problem is they have to, you know, beat the recruitment difficulty to basically get them, so it can be somewhat difficult. We'll try and recruit you for sure. I probably should get that treated now. I've only been doing everything by myself, you know? They've been bludgeoned and pistoled and everything else, these guys. Okay, he's gonna be difficult to recruit, but he's got some, you know, stuff going for him. He's a hard worker and our stuff. We'll see if he wants to join us. And that corpse is a bit of an issue at this point. That has to be dealt with. What's Spork doing? You're making pants. You know, that is important, but how about you prioritize making me, you know, not die? I kinda like the idea. Yeah, they're actually so far away, these guys, that I'm not sure how beneficial it's going to be for them, being so far away. I'm looking at it, I may want to have someone else doing the warding here. Manage, feed, chat with, and recruit prisoners. Kind of interesting having that attack that happened right there. And all the people are walking, it's cool. There was lots of that medicine there, but whatever. Go help out Zeke. We're doing okay. I do need to get more components at some point. And all this lovely silver over here. Need to get that too. Jade. Nice. A chunk of spacecraft can be deconstructed to yield useful steel and components. That's good to know. We'll deconstruct those for, you know, stuff. So Zeke's getting healed. And full healed, awesome. I'm gonna go deconstruct some stuff. Another day's passed, apparently. Too bad you can't really train this guy to be more, you know, capable of stuff, whatever. BossGalaga, not doing too well. There's a way to basically see, like, you know, stats on, like, stuff. To try and figure out how that works. Like, you actually see, like, the beauty and, like, stuff, like, inside, like, these buildings every so often if you want. Cool, you're gonna go feed Zeke. Was nuzzled by Deep. Cute. Nuzzled. Nice thing about cute animals to make you very happy. Alright, looks like Matt's gonna try and get Zeke to join us. I don't think Zeke is going to join us too easily, but whatever. We'll see what the chance of recruiting Zeke is here, I guess. Ouch, there's only like a 0.5% chance of recruiting Zeke. Well, I guess it's probably good, you know, good to see, I guess, right there. I'll heal him up, and then if he doesn't join, I'll just, like, send him on his way. Oh, good, we're going to bury this one. So we're just going to go heal someone again. How's Cornish doing? Cornish is actually not doing, you know, too great. He should be, like, you know, healed up. Whatever. Heal up Ma'am here a little bit. Slowly getting healed up. Carson's not doing too well. Oh well, poor result. But they're bandaged. Slowly getting banished up. Uh-oh. So Cornish now has an infection. The infection's in his neck. Ensure you have a medical bed and a doctor. Make sure Cornish Knight gets proper treatment and spends as much time in bed as possible. So infections are bad. It's possible you can die from infections in this game, and it's possible you might lose Cornish right here. Sorry, Cornish, your time in my let's play might be very limited in this one. This is our coffee guy for him. Zeke also has an infection, apparently. Infection in his torso. Ouch. You know, looking at it now, I don't really need all this power, but whatever. If he fights off the infection, he'll be good, Cornish, but if he doesn't, he's gonna die. Yeah, infection, minor and untreated. Minor and untreated for now. If he builds up immunity, great. If not, he's gonna die. You're gonna try and recruit Zeke, go for it. We like to play chess by ourselves for some reason. Whatever. Guess we failed to recruit Zeke. I'm only going to keep his gear for now, but I may have to strip him if he doesn't want to give his stuff. Or he doesn't want to join us. That recruitment diff is really, really bad, you know, to say the least. Mam has an infection. So, infection in her left arm. That's not too bad, that can be treated, sort of. A torus has gone bad, nuts. Well, he's all the way over here, so it'll be a while. When he gets a chance, Mam will go kill him. Speaking of hunting. Yes, here it comes. It wants to kill us. Hey, Corsair got up. Guess he's gonna consume a simple meal and go back to bed. Bang, bang, bang. Wow, that's a nice way of doing it. Just bomb it right there a little bit. Go back to try and recruit people. That's still pretty bad to recruit, but whatever. Hopefully it'll go up over time. Oh, nice. Mam put on some stuff there. That's a bit of an issue. Mam's gone berserk. She's sort of trapped in there, but she's berserk. I guess you can cower out there for a little bit, but how about you just get over here? Man, might calm down, perhaps, maybe. Or she'll kill Zeke. Get them over here and just take care of them. There we go. Capture. Capture. They're gonna need more medical attention now, but whatever. Alright, right, let's just barf on the poor bastards. Gonna try and recruit them again. Oh well. Yes, prisoners. They like to do stuff like that, you know. Let's go berserk. Well, 1.5 is going up. He's not really going up, but whatever. Maybe it'll join at some point. The sarcophagi for Cornish Knife ever dies. Probably get some hospital beds going in the future. Hey, look at that. Matt's gone back to kill this guy. More shooting skill. Wait, I'm consuming a simple meal, or he, that's really whatever. Whatever. Well, you're getting treated again. Well, that's a major infection now. I may want to cut off her left arm before it spreads that infection. Her immunity is going up though. She might be okay. My squirrel meat rotted away apparently. That sucks. Interesting how this guy decided to stop attacking us, I guess. He's no longer a man, the tortoise. He's just really, really injured. All right, I think what we're gonna do, we're just gonna wait for just the end and we'll call it for this video. In a severe illness. So Cornish Knife has a severe illness from probably his infection. He might be okay. He's getting his immunity up there. Wow, his jaw was shot off. Apparently, Cornish Knight was is now jawless. Sleeping we go. What's wrong with you? So, BossGalaga apparently has, he's been insulted, he's disturbed sheep, shared bedroom, ate without a table, all the lovely stuff there, I guess. I'll have to fix it all eventually. Oh, Cornish Knight died. We lost Cornish Knight, apparently. Oh well. It's unfortunate. That's what happens with infections, you know. I really need to get another doctor, I guess, so I can treat more people. Oop, Zeke died. Strip him, I guess. My friend Zeke died. No! Just, he's not having a good day. Well, I guess this is probably a good stopping point. A lot of stuff has happened. Cornish is dead. One of the prisoners died. We'll see how it goes in the future, but for now, take care.